Okay, fine. So fixed point method or iteration method. I will make it means straightforward. Let's not drag the issue here. Fixed point. By this time, you could have come to conclusion that CM course is very simple. Yes or not? Very easy, right? What is there? F of x he will give. Initial guesses he must give. We have to follow algorithm steps and that's it. Yes or not? It's very easy, right? Don't you agree with this? Is it easy or not here? Do you think is it simple or not? Why only 50 participants? Class CR. Santosh.
Yes, sir.
What is your class strength here?
58.
58. What happened to remaining candidates? Do you know?
I don't know, sir.
So please monitor the attendance, okay? See, please, yes. Please list down the absentees. And what about the previous class? For the previous class, how many of you were present? How many of you were present in your previous class?
Actually, I'll
once take it and I'll let you know. Okay, what about other CR? Girl CR, who is she?
Yes, sir.
Satvika, how many of you were present in the previous, I mean, in this previous class? No idea?
No idea, sir.
Please make a note of, please just skim through, just see who are absent in at least CM's class, okay?
Okay, because, sir, from today we will
because, yeah, the thing is that absentees cannot be tolerated for any, under any circumstances. This is true. So please, please list down the absentees. Tomorrow I will talk to them. Okay. Tomorrow in the lab, I'll talk to them. Please, please list down the absentees and then WhatsApp me. Okay. Is it okay, Satvika? Are you there?
Yes, sir. Okay, sir.
Okay, fine. Thank you. So, fixed point iteration method. Our my ultimate goal is what? I need to solve an equation of the form Mr. F of x equal to 0, say. This is my ultimate goal. Okay? So, this method is carried out by rewriting the equation. Whatever given equation you have, see this equation f of x equal to 0, you have to write this equation of this format x equal to g of x. Okay? So fixed point method base is this. Given an equation, write in this format, like x equal to g of, you will come to know how to write this. It's not a big deal, okay? So once you know this, and this g of x is called as, generally this g of x is iteration function. Now what I will do here, you know, for example, I have, this is my x and this is say my y. Y is equal to f of x, say. So what I want to say, like y equal to f of x, okay? Now, for example, I have, this is my true solution, xts. So near to this true solution, I will take somewhere here my initial guess, say x1. Near to this true solution, I'll take some x1, okay? Now, this x1 I will put. So this x1, I'll put in this g of x. So when I put x1 in this g of x, now I would get some g of x1, okay? Now this g of x1 becomes the next iteration, the next estimate x2. So x2 equal to g of x1. Now what I'll do, once we get x2, again I put x2 in g of x. So if I do so, I'll get g of x2. Now this g of x2 becomes the new estimate x3. So I think 95% of you didn't understand like this, but I have a method for this. I'll tell you how to do this. Okay, so similarly, what I'll do now, I'll put down all the things, okay? I'll correct all the things. So let me put down the things like this. So this guy, that means I take, this is some xi, for example. So xi, I will put this xi in this g of x. So now I'll find g of xi, okay? And this g of xi, now this becomes the new estimate, xi plus 1. Are you able to understand this? Maybe you're not convinced at this juncture, but you know, eventually things will work out, okay? But now this guy, this g of x, whatever you say, or otherwise I can say in general, this g of x is called as iteration function. I mean this g of x is called as iteration function. Yeah, so end of the day, this is what the estimation you have. Xi plus 1 equal to g of xi is the estimation, okay? So now I will show you how to make this happen, how to connect, or how can we make, for example, you have f of x equal to 0. So this f of x equal to 0, we have to convert to x equal to g of x. This you will understand from an example, okay? So that we will see. But first of all, we will try to understand this xi plus 1 equal to g of xi. How come we use this to find numerical solution for a given problem? All right. So I'll just take my scale. Okay. Let me draw. All right, scale po. So this guy is x, and say this is like f of x, but I'll take y is equal to f of x to make this stuff simple. Y, now you tell me, what I'm doing here is I'm writing what your x equal to g of x, yes or not? F of x equal to 0, we are writing in x equal to g of x form. So left hand side I have x, right hand side I have g of x. So I will show both on one plot, okay? So how do I do that, you see? Now I will take Mr. X. Mr. X is something like this. Say, okay, I'll make it happen like. Are you able to understand this? This is what here? Y equal to X, right? Agree?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, this is Y equal to X. Now I'll draw Mr. G of X. Come G of X, say, okay. G of X is some non-linear curve like this. Some Y equal to X is linear stuff. And g of x, you may have something non-linear stuff. Let me draw it even better. G of x is not beautiful. Need proper. Okay, again, I do something similar to the previous one, but this is fine, okay? So now, you know what is fixed point here? Now we have to justify the title, okay? The title is Mr. Fixed Point. I must justify the title, so I can do that. I can justify the title with the help of this CHOTU dot. And this guy is fixed point. I hope you got this, okay? So this is the fixed point between the blue curve and the orange curve, y equal to x and y equal to gx. For God's sake, you should know this. And this must be like y equal to g of x. Okay, so on the left hand side you have x, right hand side you have g of x. So we displayed two plots and we superimposed these two plots, and these two plots, and there is an intersection at this quantity, at this junction here. And you know, so this guy, so this guy is going to be what here? True solution, yes or not? So this guy is going to be true solution. And now who is Mr. Fixed Point here? Yeah. So I would say this, or simply I would say this is my true solution, or this guy is my fixed point. Okay, the intersection point is my fixed point. So I will jot it down with the help of this. Now I would see, how do I apply this iteration form? Xi plus 1 equal to g of xi. Okay, so now what do I do is, let me see. Always, whenever you're dealing with open methods, the initial estimate or the initial guess, if it is not given to you, what you have to choose, or how you have to choose? You have to choose something which is very close to the true value, yes or not? So the same approach we follow here as well. So I will take something randomly somewhere here, okay? Let me make this thin now. I will use this. I will use some other color. What color I can use? I will use this yellow, Mr. Yellow. Mr. Yellow is this. So this is my true value, say. My XTS is this, okay? So I'll take some initial guess X1 here. Now what do I do? At x1, what do I do here? I will go until I meet this blue curve, okay? And now this is g of x1. Agree up to this? I took x1, which is close to xts, okay? Now at x1, I went from x1 up, okay? I took an upwards journey and I meet my blue curve, y equal to g of x, at which we found g of x1. Do you agree with this?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, once you get this, now you will have to nod your heads, because you see, now once I have this, I'll take a journey towards y equal to x, okay? Now I'll meet y equal to x here. See, from here, I came all the way. So I'm moving all the way like this, at y equal to x. Now, but ultimately, your ultimate goal is what here? You have to move always towards whom? Y equal to g of x, yes or not? So sometimes directly you can reach g of x directly, like the one you have with x1. And sometimes you will first meet with y equal to x, then from there you will meet with y equal to g of x. But end of the day, your ultimate goal is, your destination is, you have to go to g of x, okay? So the moment I'm here, the moment I came here, I project down this. Okay, this is what now? This is next estimate x2, agree? This is next estimate x2, but where should I move? I should move to g of x, okay? So therefore, my journey is towards g of x. Are you able to understand this? I must go like this, g of x, yes or not? So now this point is what here? What is this point here now?
G of x2, sir.
Very good, this is g of x2. Now, what is the value of c? Now, what do I say? Can I say that x2 is equal to g of x1? Because
yes, sir.
This point is g of x1. You're traveling on the same line towards left. That means the entire stuff, this entire stuff is g of x1 itself. So I could say this x2 is equal to g of x1. Yes or not? Please don't confuse with this, okay? Of course, at x2, you have g of x2 on the blue curve. But if you observe carefully, if you take this, because from g of x1, you are moving all the way to y equal to x. And from here, you came all the way down and you marked x2. And from here, your ultimate goal is you should reach g of x2, this g of x curve. You moved up and you marked down. And as you have g of x1 here, you must have again same g of x1 here. So therefore, I could say x2 equal to g of x1. From here, now what do I do? From here, what do I do now? Again, our ultimate goal is what here? I have to reach my g of x somehow, okay? So I am at g of x2 now. Now from here, I will again travel right. Okay, let me use this color. Okay, so I travel, now I traverse down the way. Now I will meet here. First time meeting, of course, y equal to x. Now what I'll do when I meet this, now what's my ultimate goal here? I have to meet whom? I have to meet g of x, okay? So I'll come down like this. And here, now what is this point here? If you project this point down, now this point is what here? X3, agree?
Yeah.
Yeah, at yes, X3, sir. Now this is what here? See, this is g of x2. Now what is this one? This is also g of x2, right? See, this is g of x2. This is what now?
G of x2.
X2 only, right? So x3 is equal to g of x2. So x3 equal to g of x2. Now what about this point here? This is g of x3. Yes or not?
Yes, sir.
The difference you have to observe when you are, when we are meeting that y equal to x line, there you have to take x value on the x axis. You have to project down from there to x axis and then take some different x1, x2, x3, whatever. But on the curve, wherever you meet, and that you have to take, I mean, a special care like that, okay? So again, now I'll make it big to make it possible. Now again, what do I do? So again, I will take some journey towards left. I hope you're clear, okay? I took a journey something like this. I came all the way down. Now I took this journey, okay? Now the same thing, this guy is meeting with y equal to x first. So again, I will project this fellow. So first you do this task. When you meet y equal to x, first you project down, okay? Now, okay, things becoming complex now. So this is what here, x4, right? So this is x4, okay? What is x4 now? Can I say x4 is equal to g of x3? Can I say?
Yes, sir.
Because, see, because this guy is g of x3. I'm traveling on the same line. On the same line, everywhere I will have g of x3 only. So y equal to, I mean, x4 equal to g of x3. But ultimate goal is what? I have to reach whom? I have to reach Mr. g of x, okay? So from here, I will go to this. I'll go to the blue curve, which is my g of x, okay? Now what is this? What is this one here? G of x4 or g of x3? See, g of x3. G of x3 is this. Now this guy is g of x4, okay? I will write it here. So this guy is g of x4. Now similarly, so on, what you do? Again, I will go to this orange. From here, I will again meet this. See, finally, what are you doing here? You are going to answer, right? Yes or not? Finally, you are converging to the answer. Agree? Your ultimate goal is somewhere you have to start your initial guess, that somewhere must be close to the true solution. And the ultimate goal is you have to reach the fixed point. The fixed point is intersection point of y equal to x and y equal to g of x. Yeah, clear? I hope we are clear thus far. Right?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, and that's the beauty of xi plus 1 equal to g of xi is this, okay? But please don't confuse here. But here you see you're saying x1 g of x1. No, this is a coordinate. This is nothing but what? X1 comma g of x1. And our journey started somewhere here. Okay, then you have, see, everywhere xi plus 1 is equal to g of xi. Again, xi plus 1 equal to g of xi. Everywhere. You can see that everywhere, okay? So this is a strategy in reaching out to the solution, okay? Now I'll take the other case. I'll take some models, model graphs. Okay, so let me draw. So I'll draw this. So this is my y equal to x. So this guy, so this is my y. So he is Mr. X. And this fellow is y is equal to x. All right. Now I'll take another curve. I'll take another curve, something like this. This is my curve this time, okay? And I would say this blue curve is y equal to g of x, okay? Now, where is the fixed point here? Where is the fixed point? The fixed point is here, agree? This is my fixed point. Now you come down, you project down, and this becomes what now? The true solution. Yes or not? On x-axis, you have this true solution. Andarki ardham avutunda?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now what do I do? Now I'll start my journey with this. I will take some initial guess, say x1 like this. I will take somewhere here from xts somewhere here. See xts is here. I'll take and let me take x1 somewhere here. Okay. Now from here I will try to find out my what at x1. I will find my g of x1. Rendu scale manaku kavali. Okay. So at x1. Okay. So I'll go like this. Okay. So we are meeting here now. So this becomes what? G of x1. Now what is my ultimate goal? I have to reach my g of x again. But how do I reach? So I'm just taking vertical horizontal directions. So once I have this g of x1, I'll come like this and I'll go all the way here. Agree? So I'll stop here, okay? I'll stop here. Now what do I do? Now I'll project this. So first of all, okay, projecting means I will see at which point of x I have that. Okay? Now at which point of x here? Can I see x2 now? Yeah, x2. So but ultimate goal is what? My ultimate goal is I have to reach every time to g of x only, okay? So I'll come all the way down. So I'll meet here now. Now this point is what? At x2, this point is what? This
g of x2.
g of x2. But you tell me what is the value here? This is again, of course, g of x1. Agree? Yes or not? That value is g of x1. Now what do I do? Because my ultimate goal is I have to make every time x equal to g of x. On the left hand side I want x, on the right hand side I want this g of x. So therefore I will take x2 is equal to g of x1. Or you see, I'm not writing like this here. You have to understand this. I am not writing like this. X2 is equal to g of x2. Why? Because on the left side, whatever you have, that must be a linear graph. Y equal to x, yes or not? So therefore I'm taking this white curve. Now when you project this point here, you have x2. So x2 is equal to this g of x1. I hope you are clear with this. So therefore now this guy x2 is equal to, we can take now g of x1. All right. Now again, what do you do? That means we started here and we came this way. Now again, what do we do? Again from here. Yeah. From here again, you move towards this. Okay. Just move like that. Now you are meeting with whom again? This fellow. Now proceed. I mean, you come down from here. This is what you are now. X3, right? X3. Now, and this, of course, this is g of x2. So this must be also g of x2. Yes or not? But ultimate goal is you have to reach where? I have to reach my curve, the blue curve. You came down like this. And this point is what now?
G of x3.
Very good. That's it. G of x3. Now, by this time, you have an hope, right? Now, again, I will move towards left like this. You see, I'm almost moving to the answer now. Yes or not? This is how convergence of a solution using a fixed point method. Okay, now I will show you divergence of fixed point interest method. See, here there is convergence. In the previous case also you have convergence. Okay, now again, what do? I'll just take this scale. So I'll just take the scale. Let me draw this. So I have here again, let me plot this one as well. So this is X and this is Y. So I'll take again this ruler. So my job is simple now. Now I'll show you the divergence case, okay? So this guy is like Y is equal to X. Okay, I'll draw my blue curve again. Now my blue curve is something like this. So now this is the intersection point here. It's my fixed point here. So therefore, this is my true solution. So now what do I do? So now I will take, let me take some x1 somewhere here, okay? So I will take some x1 here. I just took x1 here now. So I'm meeting here, but where do you meet here? First of all, what you must get? I must find x1, okay? At x1, I will find this one, right? I want this coordinate first. x1, comma, g of x1, yes or not? Yes or not? Yes or no? I want this coordinate. First of all, you must mark this coordinate, x1, comma, g of x1. From there, you have to take vertical or horizontal directions. Agree? Agree or not? Yeah. So therefore, where should I go now? Shall I stop at y equal to x or shall I go to y equal to g of x? Where should I go now? Where should I go, man? To get this coordinate, where should I go?
G of x, sir.
Y equal to g of x, no? So therefore, I'm going like this. So I'll make it, so this is my, all right. So I'm reaching here. Now I have g of x1 here. Okay. So this is my g of x1. There is no second thought. So write down here, this is g of x1. And from here, what do? Now, okay, I move like this. I'll move this way. I'm meeting with this guy, y equal to x. Now I'll come down. So I'll come down at x2. Okay. So this is x2. Whereas your curve is something like this. Let me draw my curve this way. I drew a very steep curve. Say you have your curve something like this. Okay. Okay. Anyways, I'll leave the previous curve only. All drawings will become awkward otherwise. Okay. So this guy is going all the way something like this. This guy is going this way. Now what do I do? From here to where should I go here? I should go like this. Agree? Yes or not?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, I must go like this. So now, yeah, this point is g of x1. So this point is also g of x1. Okay. So x2 is equal to g of x1. But at x2, what do you have? I want coordinate, right? At x2, what do you have? You have g of x2. Agree? The coordinate is at x2, you have g of x2. So this fellow is my g of x2. Agree? So this fellow is my g of x2. And what about this fellow? So this fellow is going on like this, y equal to x. Now again, what do I do? Again, I must come like this. I must go this way. Right? So now, differentially, so again, project down. You project down again. And he becomes what here? X3. Okay? Now, if this is g of x2, this is also g of x2. So therefore, I would say x3 is equal to g of x2. Agree? But where is your curve here? My curve is, say, like this. But first of all, you tell me, are you moving towards the solution now? First of all, tell me.
No, sir, we are diverging.
Yeah, you have fixed point somewhere here. But you see, though the initial guess is very close to the true solution somewhere here, but still I could not reach my solution. My solution is somewhere here, but I'm moving like this. I'm moving this way. My solution is towards left. I'm moving towards right. So did you converge in this case? No. Yeah. You know, what is the reason for this? The reason could be, maybe initial guess is of course close to the solution, but the reason could be g of x. I hope you will come to know this is a very interesting one. The reason could be the nature of g of x. The nature of g of x is important in this case, because you see, everywhere you have, see, I have orange color y equal to x and blue color y equal to g of x. And for this g of x, now we converged, right? So we approached convergence. And the previous case, I mean, the other example we took, I mean, this case, see, in this case also, the g of x is something this way. And of course, x1 is somewhat close to x2s, and still you converged here. But when you compare to the first case, see, the first case you have exponential decay kind of thing. And here you have some growth kind of thing, exponential growth for y equal to g of x. In this case also, you have y equal to g of x as growth, but whatever. But this is completely different one, right? When compared to case 1 and case 2, case 3 is completely a different one. So for this g of x, so if you treat this g of x and we landed at divergence. Now there is no point of convergence at any cost. You are diverging now, okay? So this guy is diverging. I hope you are able to, understand things. The one thing what you have to understand is that the convergence also depends on the nature of g of x. When I say nature, maybe the shape, okay, or the behavior. Are you able to understand these things or not yet? Just confirm me.
Yes, sir, we are understanding.
You are able to understand. And the last case what you have is this. And then we'll stop. It will take around 2 minutes. The last case is this. So one thing is very important, okay? So nature of g of x. So a nature of iteration function. So nature of iteration function has a dominant role, okay? So this is very important, okay? So this guy is really important. Nature of iteration function g of x. But not for all g of x you have convergence. So convergence or divergence, that also depends upon the nature of g of x. So again, you have the last case for today. Is this? This is my say x. And this is my say g of x. This color I'll take here. Let me take Mr. Orange. So this is like, it's not going, okay? This is Mr. Y equal to X. So I'll take now G of X, something like this. So what's wrong? I'll take something like this, my G of X this time, okay? So this point, this is my fixed point here, okay? So at this fixed point, so you come down, you meet Mr. X axis, and this is what your XTS, agree? Now I'll take, now see, for this g of x or whatever, I'll take again x1 very close to it. I'll take different color for this. I'll take this color, okay? So I'll take this one. Let me take x1 like this. I'm just taking very close to it. So first of all, I need to find what coordinate, right? X1 comma g of x1. So you find the coordinate here. So this coordinate, you have x1 comma g of x1. So this is your g of x1, okay? From here, what do? You move towards this. You move towards this, and this is what here? G of x1, right? This is again g of x1. This is again g of x. So what is this one here? X2, right? Yes or not?
Yes, sir.
So this, I mean, this is what now, let me make it bold now, okay? This is what here? G of x2, agree? Now at x2, what do you have? You have x2 is equal to g of x1. X2 comma g of x2, that's coordinate point, okay? Differential, now I will come from here to here. I'll come. So this is also Mr. G of X2. So this is also G of X2. Okay. So at this, I want to take the projection here. And this becomes X2. So X2 is equal to what? This is X2, right? This is X3. This is X3. So this is G of X2 because this is also G of X2. Now again, you're meeting here. Okay. You came and you're meeting here now. And this becomes what here? G of x3. Again, from here, where do you go? From here, you have to come like this. Okay. If you observe carefully, now you're moving out. Okay. So you're diverging out. I'm moving up here. Again, towards right. Again, I'm here. Again, I'm coming down. See, like a spider web, what I'm doing now? I'm moving out. Yes or not? Yes or not? My answer is somewhere here, but I'm moving out. Are you able to understand this?
Yes, sir.
Divergence. So in the next class, we will see for what kind of g of x, for what nature of g of x you have these problems, okay? So based on that, we will Lipschitz condition. There is one Lipschitz condition. That condition will help us to choose the right g of x for to make f of x equal to 0 as x equal to g of x. So that we will try to understand. So we'll stop here. Thank you very much. Do you have any questions here? Yes or no?
No, sir, no question.